For the probably 3 years of university, I didn't draw a single thing, nothing. I did nothing artistic, zero. You know, it wasn't until kind of my third year, I remember I was sort of like attempting to take a mental break from some awful engineering course. And I was still very into horses. I had a horse magazine on my desk, and I just sort of started like drawing, like drawing whatever the horse that was on the cover. So I'm like, oh, and like it kind of struck me, like, oh my God, I forgot how I used to love drawing. And it had gone from me for that time. Yeah. So that's when I kind of got that little, you know, snippet again.
Mm-hmm. You know, I think that's a very common thing too, with, like you said, a lot of creative people who they have a passion to pursue something, yet there's different opportunities that come and kind of life happens, or maybe it's the practical voices that say, you know, I don't know if you're really going to be able to make a living at this, or there are just other things that feel more responsible and more adult. And those are the things that a lot of times that push us forward. And then yet we find this place where we're lacking on that expression. Yeah. And I know, you know, for me, that was, you know, I had a 10-year gap where I didn't do any of my personal art, and that really messed with me, ultimately led to depression. Yeah. Because I think sometimes we don't realize how important that is, that even if that isn't our livelihood, yeah, we still need to keep that place within ourselves. We need to keep tabs with it and keep leaning into that and expressing our creativity in whatever ways that we can. Because when we don't, I think that we can get frustrated and not even really realize why, right? I mean, was that your experience at that point? Was it like you're rediscovering and going, oh yeah, I remember I used to do this. I used to love this.